Classification according to hydraulic design. Here mainly it is having two classifications. One is non-overflow dam and overflow dam. For suppose now I will say this is our dam. Okay, this is our crust, we can say. Just now I said, for suppose the height is up to say 150 meter. The height is up to 150 meter. For here 150 meter height. Exactly at 140 meter or somewhere here, if you are releasing water in this direction, so what will happen? Whenever we are releasing water, means what? Here height will be decreased. So why overflow will come? Overflow, just we can say in concrete lab, we can see whenever excess water it is there, immediately flow overflow will be there. Okay. To control this one, what we have to observe? To control this one, we are taking the help of crust. What we are taking? We are taking the help of crust. Water is not permitted to over top of the dam. For suppose if it is 150 meter, immediately at 100 meter we will start releasing the water. Whenever we are releasing the water, what will happen? Overflow chances will be less, and our structures won't be damaged. Okay, water is not permitted to over the top of the dam. Okay, means as per rules, we will decide one height. Means for suppose whether it is 120 meter or 130 meter, whatever it is, it won't cross. Okay. Next, what are the materials used? Earth, stock fill, masonry, concrete. Here, what is stock fill? Stock fill is nothing but it is like material like aggregate. Small aggregate will be there. That one I will show in my next class. Okay. Next, overflow dam. Overflow dam is designed to carry surplus discharge, including floods, over the crust. Just now I said, for suppose if it is water is crossing the level of this height, immediately what will happen? Overflow will be there. That one we can say as flood. Next, crust level is kept lower than the top of the other position of the dam. Means how we have to decide our height, I will say for us. If you go to our PWD offices, okay, we will have some rainfall. In 2020, how much rainfall it is there? In 2019, how much rainfall it is there? And it like that, like this, we have to collect the data. In previous 5 years, how much rainfall it is there? In before 10 years, how much rainfall it is there? In before 15 years, how much rainfall it is there? Like this, what we have to do? We have to collect the data, and based on that collection of data, we may get one conclusion. How much if we are constructing the reservoir? Okay, up to how much height the water is coming? Okay, based on that we have to design. For suppose if you are not collecting that data blindly, you are making for support the based on, okay, don't we can't say that blindly, we can say for suppose overall height, if you see average height, if you are providing 85 meter, it is safe, it is okay, but you have provided only 90 meter, but this year rainfall is more, or next 5 years rainfall is more, means what will happen? Now it came up to 95 meter. Okay, so here what will happen? Overflow chances will be there. Okay, so we have to take care of this one, commonly known as spillway. Okay, spillway, where it will be there? Here it will be there. And river valley projects combines both. For suppose rivers are there, small rivers are there, if water is coming, what will happen? Overflow will be there. If water is not there, no overflow. Okay, if for suppose in recently we have seen 2 to 3 years back, the rainfall rate has decreased, and again it has increased. Okay, next, classification according to material. Here according dams are classified into different types. One is solid masonry or concrete gravity dam. That is concrete or masonry, you know, still generally we have seen. Next one is arched masonry or concrete dam. What is this arched? Arched will be like this. Okay, this is our arched dam. Next, concrete buttress dam. This is our concrete buttress dam, you can see. What is this one? Concrete buttress dam. Means concrete will be filled at large height of structures. Okay. Next, steel dam. Next one is timber. Steel, you know, like reinforcement is all you can say. Next, timber means, you know, wood. Next, non-rigid dams. These are which are constructed of non-rigid dam material, such as earth and sock fill. This sock fill I will show in next class. Okay. Classified as earth dam Rockefeller Dam, Combined Earth and Rockefeller Dam. What is Rockefeller? For suppose, see here, this is our dam, you can say, our masonry structure, or wall, you can say. In this area, what we will do? We will fill with rocks. With small, small rocks, we will fill. Okay, like this, we can provide Rockefeller Dam. Next, types of dam. Here, we are having, now, in our first module is about gravity dams. What is our first module? Gravity dams. Okay, and based on structural action, dams are classified into different types. Gravity dam, I will show you. Okay, next, Archer Dam, just I have shown you like this. For suppose, this is our Archer Dam. Okay, Buttress Dam, I have shown. Timber Dam is just, you know, but nowadays, most of the time, we are having concrete availability, these are. So, generally, we can provide gravity dam, these are. Okay, next, Earth Dam, we can provide, Lockfield Dam, we can provide. Okay, Buttress Dam also, just now, I have shown. And coming to gravity dam. What is gravity dam? Just I will show the structure here for you. See here. This is our gravity dam. Here how what it is there? Here water it is there. This is water part. And see this wall, how it is there? It is in inclined. How it is there? It is in inclined. Here what is happening? For suppose water is coming like this. Due to this gravity, means just you can say uniformly varying load. See here. Like this. This inclined part we can say as gravity retaining wall. The most danger means whatever the gravity wall you are constructing, here the most effective part is here water pressure. What is water pressure? Whatever the structure it is here, whenever we are constructing the dam dissolve, the main problem is here for us water pressure. We have to control that water pressure. What we have to do? We have to control that water pressure. Okay. Now, gravity dam is the one which external forces such as water pressure, wave pressure, silt pressure, uplift pressure, etc. Water pressure just now I have shown. Okay. Next, wave pressure, that is like wind force we can say. Next, silt pressure is nothing but sand. What is silt pressure? Silt pressure is nothing but sand. Okay. Means the combination of all this one, like uplift pressure also you can say, the combination of all this one we may call as weight of the dam. What we can say? Weight of the dam. Next, does the force distributing the stability of the dam are resisted by gravity force of the mass of the dam? Means if you see here, what is happening? The overall weight it is distributing. The overall weight it is distributing, and it is depending on wave pressure, silt pressure, water pressure, uplift pressure. Okay. Now, generally it is constructed in masonry of the or of the concrete. Okay. Either masonry you can say or concrete you can say. Mesh. Just now I have shown you how that dam construction everything will be there. Now, components are same. Just we have seen in our before. Here there is a crust, downstream, spillway, sluiceway, toe, hill, gallery, freeboard, maximum water level, normal water level, and upstream is input and downstream is output production. Forces. What are the forces we are having? Self weight we are having, hydraulic pressure we are having, uplift force we are having, wave pressure we are having, wind pressure we are having, and seismic force. Okay. First of all, we will see about self weight. Here, just see here. The self weight of the dam is main stabilizing force which counterbalances all the external forces acting on it. Just now I have shown you. For suppose, this is the dam. Okay. Here water pressure is there, wind pressure it is there, wave pressure. For suppose, see here, water is coming in this direction. If we can't say, how water will come. For suppose, in rainy season, water flow rate will be more, and in normal season water flow rate will be less. Okay, based on season varying, what is happening here? The flow rate will be changed. Okay, that is common, we have seen in many ways. Okay, the entire means how much forces are coming, this all will control by self weight. This all will control by self weight. For construction of gravity dams, okay, means whether you are constructing masonry or concrete, we have to remember one डेंसिटी दैट इज इफ इट इज कॉन्क्रीट इट इज 2400 केजी पर मीटर क्यूब एंड इफ इट इज स्टोन इट इज 2300 केजी पर मीटर क्यूब रेस्पेक्टिवली. ओके फॉर ग्रेविटी डैम दिस इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट वी हैव टू रिमेंबर प्लीज रिमेंबर स्टूडेंट्स. ओके मीन्स वॉट इज सल्फेट एंटायर विंड फोर्स वॉट एवर इट इज द एंटायर फोर्स इट इज कंट्रोलिंग द इट इज कंट्रोलिंग बाय सल्फेट. ओके द सल्फेट ऑफ ग्रेविटी डैम एक्ट्स एट द सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी फॉर सपोज दिस इज अ ग्रेविटी डैम. ओके एग्जैक्टली एट द सेंटर. ओके सल्फेट विल बी एक्ट. नेक्स्ट इट इज कैलकुलेटेड बाय द फॉर्मुला W इज इक्वल टू गामा एन टू एम इन टू वॉल्यूम. वॉट इज गामा एम हियर स्पेसिफिक हेट ऑफ डैम्स मीटर फॉर सपोज इफ यू आर प्रेफरिंग कॉन्क्रीट 2400 इफ यू आर प्रेफरिंग मैसनरी 2300 इन टू वॉल्यूम. वॉट इज वॉल्यूम लेंथ इन टू ब्रेथ इन टू हाइट. ओके नेक्स्ट हाइड्रोलिक प्रेशर वाटर प्रेशर इज द मोस्ट एक्सटर्नल फोर्स एक्टिंग ऑन ए ग्रेविटी डैम. वॉट आई सेड फॉर सपोज दिस इज अवर ग्रेविटी डैम. ओके हियर वॉट विल हैपन वाटर प्रेशर विल बी देर. What will happen here? Water pressure will be there more. And this is the external force we can say. Means by combination of all force if you see the most dangerous part is here water pressure. Okay. On upstream phase pressure exerted by water is stored up to fill the reservoir level. The upstream phase may be either vertical or inclined. Okay. Means here just see the structure. Here we are having upstream level. Here maximum level, normal water level. Here what will happen? Water will be stored. Water will be stored. Means this part, the upstream part, either you may provide vertical or inclined. That is, designer will be decide this one. Okay. And coming to downstream, where downstream will be there? Here will be there. But remember one thing, this downstream is always inclined. This downstream is always inclined. Okay. Next, it is calculated by the following formula. Okay. What is the formula? P is equal to half into gamma W into H square, where gamma W is unit weight of water. What is unit weight of water? 10. Either 10 gram per centimeter or 10 kilonewton per 1000 newton per kg per meter cube. Okay, and H is nothing but height of water. Okay, now see here what is happening. If you see here, this is our upstream side and this is our downstream side. Okay, here what is happening? Water is touching to the dam, means continuous water flow will be there. Okay, and here if I am providing one upstream part, what I am doing here? Upstream part I am providing here. Due to this upstream, what is happening here? Water will be stored for me. Water is getting storage. Okay, due to this storage, what is how it is there? It is inclined. If you are providing upstream part inclined, then only you can store the water. If you are providing horizontal, how much distance you will provide? Okay, that's why we will provide only inclined part and downstream part is always inclined. Okay, this one is vertical and this one is inclined. Okay, and this is about today's lecture. Thank you. Hope you have understood. If you are having any doubts, please contact me immediately and I will provide notes with in this session only. You can go through it. And if you see this structure, this is Orchard Dam. This is Orchard Dam. Okay. Thank you, friends. Take care.